Welcome back. In the last video, we set up the collection function. We did it with a test log string so that we could show that it was working. If you see over here in the log, we get things like you have collected battery BP and then the number, also some of the you've collected pickup BP. For our gameplay though, we want the character to increase its power using the batteries in the level. That means we have to create a power variable both on the battery and on the character. So let's switch over to Visual Studio and get started doing that. Okay, so let's go to our battery header file, which let's expand this side panel here so we can find it in the Solution Explorer. And we have battery pickup.h. So we're going to have a protected variable with a public accessor function. That way there's no way to set the battery power both unless you're on the class or on a blueprint derived from that. That's just so that, say, the character can't reach into every battery and give it 5,000 power when to win you only need 1,000, something like that. So let's make a protected section here in our header. And we're going to call this, it's going to be a float variable, and we're going to call it battery power. And this will set the amount of power the battery gives to the character. And we will mark this up a little bit with the uProperty macro. And we'll get to use a new piece of metadata that we haven't used yet in this series. So again, we'll have edit anywhere, blueprint read write. So if we wanted to be able to charge up this battery within the battery blueprint, we could do that. We're going to put it in the power category. And then we're going to use this meta for blueprint protected. So we've made this variable protected in code, which means that no other C++ classes can change it unless they inherit from battery pickup. However, we need a separate flag to protect the variable in blueprints so that the only blueprints that can change this variable are those that inherit from our battery pickup. So that's just an easy little flag here with meta equals blueprint protected equals true. And then we'll go ahead and make our accessor function so that other classes like our character can know what the battery power is. So that's also just a float function. No arguments. And this will be the public way to access the battery power level. It's pretty straightforward. So we'll switch to our battery source file now. And first, right here in the constructor, we'll give a default, basically the base power level of the battery. And we'll set that to, let's go with 150. We'll definitely tweak this during our polish pass later, but 150 is just a nice number to start with. And then down here, actually, let's just check on the order back here in our header file. Get power is after was collected, so we'll just do that here too. And that is float, again, a float function, a battery pickup. Get power, and again that just returns battery power, and that'll report the power level of the battery. Now if we wanted to, or we needed to at some point later, we could come back and mark up this get power function so that could be called from blueprints, but for the steps that we're laying out in this series, we're just going to access it from code, so we're not going to necessarily mark it up as a U function. Let's go ahead and compile this and then check it out on our battery. Let's open that back up, compile. And while that's compiling, I'll go ahead and find our battery blueprint so we can check it out. Actually, we'll close these and then open it back up, and then we'll go back and add power level to our character as well. Okay, so that just finished compiling. Let's go ahead and open our battery blueprint and see our new variable. Let's see, under here under the power category, we've got battery power, and it is set to that default of 150. But here, if I wanted to override it and make it 200, power up the battery just a little bit, I could easily do that and then compile the blueprint. And go ahead and save that too. Okay, so now that we've seen it working on our battery, let's go add power level to our character. So we'll open our Visual Studio solution. And then find our character header. And our character is actually going to have two power variables, one for the power it's going to start off with, and one for the basically current power level. And the initial power is going to be protected so that we could override it in a blueprint or a subclass. But the character power, the current power level, is not going to be, it's going to be private. That way, no other class or default can change that without going through our code. So let's find protected section here. Go ahead and set up our initial power. So that's a float too. And that will be the starting power level of our character. And again, because we said we could override it in either an instance of the character or blueprints, we are going to go ahead and mark up with some of the uProperty macro keywords. We'll make this edit anywhere, blueprint read write. In that power category, and that should be all that that needs. And then right here, I don't think I saw a private section already set up in the code, so we'll just put it right here. And this will be our character power, which again is the current power level. Just go ahead and comment that. Current power level of our character. And this one is not going to be edit anywhere. It's just going to be visible so that we can take a look at it to sort of debug as we're going. And again, in the power category. So now that we've set those two variables, let's go into our constructor and set a default for initial power and then show how we're going to base character power off the initial power. So up here in the constructor at the very top, let's actually go to the bottom of the constructor, and we will set a base power level for, so initial power, we're going to set to 2000. And if you think about it, that the battery is about 150, 200, so you have to collect a number of batteries, but we're also going to have the power level drain, so it's not just, you know, pick up 10 batteries and you've doubled your power kind of thing. And then also in the constructor, we're going to say when the character is created, we're going to set character power, that initial power, or that current power level, to the initial power level. And so that's just, you know, this is the power level it's going to start with, and our character's current power will be equal to that initial power. Now we will go create those public getters. Basically, we've got the protected and private power variables, but we do want other classes to at least be able to reach out to the character and ask what those power levels are. So here are some public variables. And so we're going to need the accessor function for initial power. We're going to need one for current power. And while we're in here, we'll also just write the function to update the character's power. Because again, we don't want anybody to be able, any classes, any gameplay code, to be able to directly reach in and say, okay, the character's power level is now a million. without going through the code that we've set up to update the power. So this will be a float function, and it will get the initial power. And it's going to be a blueprint pure function, which, as we saw before, means that it's not going to have those execution pins because it's not actually changing anything. It's just returning the current value of the initial power. And the current power is going to look very much the same. In fact, I could actually even take those same macro keywords and duplicate it here. But rather than calling it get initial power, we'll call it get current power. And then the function to update the character's power is actually going to be a little bit more complicated. It's actually going to have a parameter. So it's going to be a void function called update power. And it's going to take float of power change. Now the power change can be either positive or negative. So actually, let me just move this comment around a little bit so we can add a note about the parameter. And this will also help anybody in blueprints who wants to use the function to update the power. So power change, this is the amount to change the power by. And it can be positive or negative. So if you wanted to decrease the power or increase the power, you'd use the same function, you just supply either a positive or negative value. And I did mention that we could possibly call this from blueprints if we wanted, so let's go ahead and give it that blueprint callable keyword. And the reason, again, that this one is blueprint callable and not blueprint pure is because it is actually having an effect on your character's power, and so you want to directly execute it. You don't want it to just not have that direct execution pin. Again, most of these functions are going to be fairly straightforward to set up, the same accessor that we've seen before. So to go back to the character source file here, and then below collect pickups, we will just start setting up our accessor function. So a battery collector character, and we have get initial power. And that's just going to return initial power. I can really copy most of this block, as you can see it's just the returning the variable that we're asking for. So I'm going to return character power from the get current power. And because these are fairly similar in style, let's just make sure they're commented to say reports starting power. And this one reports current power. Now update power just will do a little bit of math for us, and it's going to be again, it's going to take that float power change as an argument, and to set the new power level, it's as simple as character power is the character power plus the power change. It's not going to return the new power or anything like that. It's just going to either increment or decrement the character power based on what power change is. At this point, we can also go back and compile and see our new power level and initial power on our character. So let's go ahead and hit compile. All right, so the compile is complete. We can go to our third person folder here, open the blueprint, find our third person character, open that up, and if we wanted to type power in the search bar here, we can see both initial power and character power. We are not able to change character power, but we would be able to change initial power. Go ahead and set that back now though. And compile and save. So in this video, we added power levels to both our batteries and our character. In the next video, we'll start actually using that update power function to let the character draw power from the batteries and power up. Thanks.